record show that I said I'm coming for everything. The chatter mouse who talent don't ever doubt. If your flow ain't nowhere near this caliber, that don't count. Competition get flattened out. Getting money like I went top three in the first round. My salary that amount. They want my style, but that ain't much to be flat about. I take it as a challenge when rappers calling my status out. One of the best, and they ain't my pedigree. You can have the rings, or we did an AI's legacy. I got champion genetics.
We are sandwiched between Fort Worth and Dallas, Texas, in Arlington at the luxurious AT&T Stadium. Today, after a crazy opening weekend, it's on to week two, and we've got a good one here between the Los Angeles Chargers and the Dallas Cowboys. Two teams here fresh off week one victories. Who can keep it going as we're underway on EA Sports? Taken in at the three. And out a little across the 25 to the 27. Looking to pass, first play is Prescott. Pass incomplete, but the flag in the backfield, and this might be a roughing call.
Well, Charles, sometimes we talk about the lengths officials sometimes go to protect star quarterbacks, but that one, that was tough to argue against.
Yeah, and I'm sure that everyone's going to say, hey, we're going to administer the penalty the same way for all quarterbacks, but when it's a star back there, even more so are they going to be diligent about throwing the flag.
So the yellow flag came out, and that leads to a new set of downs for this offense. First and 10. From the shotgun, a give to Elliott. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up.
Well, this defense for the Chargers, terrific last week in the season-opening victory.
And they needed to be, because the game was a game we don't see very often anymore. Low scoring, slugging it out in the trenches. One play can make the difference type of a game, and each play took on more importance, and they got it done.
Again, it's Elliott. It'll be a gain of 5, but still about 3 yards shy of the first down marker, and now it's third down.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
Third play of this opening drive as they're looking at a 3rd and 3. Here's Prescott. And the defense has it covered. It's intercepted. Picked off by Bryce Callahan. And the Chargers are going to take over once again at their own 25-yard line.
Not something you see very often from a quarterback of his caliber, an opening drive interception.
Oh, there's no doubt in my mind that even he's surprised at how that one played out. But we know this guy is not going to stop him from continuing to fire as this game goes along. Probably give a little nod of respect across the field for that one. And let him know he'll be back the very next series.
He rifles one that's intercepted.
Well, their defense got him the football with an interception. They trot out there, Charles, and very first play, they give the football right back.
Brand, I almost expect you coming like an auctioneer. We got two. Do I hear 3? Remember, it was 2 in a row. Would we hit 3 in a row? Because these offenses, they got to be a little bit more careful as they go forward. These defenders, they're locked in and really focused.
And he'll be taken down here just shy of the 30.
No matter your experience level as a quarterback, you throw an interception on that first drive, maybe a little shaken up. Nice response there to get their first down.
I think you make an excellent point. I don't care who you are. You throw an interception, it's going to get to you.
And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down.
So 2nd and long, and got to be careful not to fall out of field goal range.
Another try after the first down sack. Prescott rolling to his left. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. He got 29 yards that time.
That's a big league job there, getting out of the pocket, not panicking, and just buying himself some time. Then he made a good, accurate throw to set up first and goal.
Flushed out right. And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down.
Oh, that's good decision making right there. Understood down and distance. Knew it wasn't third down, and he still had another opportunity to earn the first down. Good job throwing it away and avoiding an interception.
On second down, Elliott. And he's going to pull his way down to about the one-yard line. 7 big yards on the carry there to get him within range of the goal line with third down upcoming. So now things get interesting on third and goal from the one.
This almost becomes a Darwinian call, doesn't it? Almost survival of the fittest here. I know we can go all cliche. I'll go ahead and do it. Who wants it more here? Who has a better leverage at the line of scrimmage? Let's go and see what happens.
Only a yard on the sneak, not enough. And he's a few inches short for fourth down. And this is going to be nowhere close. Needed some inches and ended up losing yardage. They're turned away on fourth and goal. And the Chargers hold tight down near the goal line. The Charger drive about to get going.
But for this offense, Charles, you got to think kind of crucial here to put something together on this drive, because remember last time out, they threw the interception on the very first play.
And you can't afford to let this defense keep building any more momentum. They're playing awfully well, and they're awfully confident right now. To me, it's time to attack and take some of that momentum back. But make sure you're selective in doing so. Understand where you want to throw the football and make sure it's open before the ball leaves your hands.
Here's the first carry for Austin Ekeler. Officially nothing on that one, no gain, so they're left with still 10 to go on third down.
Ball runners count on their eyes to find the gaps and creases, to find open space. There was absolutely none on that one. Totally swallowed up on that play.
Facing the prospect of a punt from their own end zone, they need some cushion. Let's see what they can do on third down. Off the play fake to Ekeler, it's Herbert. He finds his target, Allen. And he's going to get this up to the 24-yard line. Last play, they got stuffed at the line. Different story here, over 20 yards. And that catch, he just hit number 800 in his NFL career.
And just think, that puts you in top 35 range all time in the NFL in terms of number of catches. One significant guy in that number, Shannon Sharp, who was a tight end. That's big-time play right there.
The offense knew it. They were already starting to walk back as that one is accepted.
A full start backs him up 5, first and 15. They'll fake the handoff. Now Herbert. Give him another one right back to Allen. And he'll be corralled well upfield right around the 40-yard line. They go right back to him for 20 and a first.
That's the third time on this drive that these two have connected with each other. They've got a real rapport going, and right now, it's paying off with big chunks of yardage, as shown by that last play.
Running on first down, Ekeler, and he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up. We're scoreless after one. Run got a couple here, second and 8. Justin Herbert looking to pass, and he will go down. A Cowboys sack. Jabril Cox. It'll go as a loss of about 8 as he gets in there to drop him.
They've gobbled up over 30 yards of turf so far, but a sack knocks them backwards. And that interrupts the momentum they were building. Good opportunity for the defense to escape this drive before they get to the end zone.
Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. Here's Herbert. And that will be incomplete.
That looks like it's going to be two empty possessions now to start this football game. I think they're going to have to sit down and talk about what worked for them last week in their win. Sometimes you over-game plan, overthink things. Get back to what works.
And here's a very low line drive, almost whiffed on it. And not the result they were hoping for there, at least in terms of the kick team, as that'll get out of bounds at just the 35-yard line. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. We've seen both of these offenses still sort of in that figuring things out phase, but I suspect some action on the scoreboard soon as they start. He's got a man complete. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A big pickup of 38. So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. Prescott off play action. They're looking for Lamb, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Asante Samuel Jr. And the Chargers are going to get the football back at their own 17.
Carter, I think this one went awry very simply because he overestimated his arm strength and his ability to fit it anywhere he wants to. A lot of quarterbacks do that and often pay the price.
Now a throw right side taken in here to start this drive. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. The drive starting play, a good one. Give him 19. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did. Now here's a throw right side taken in by his tight end. And they'll get him down on the other side of midfield.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus. And indeed, he gets enough for the first down.
Steps away. He finds his man complete. It's Fields. And they'll get this down to around the 47-yard line.
Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well because it was a drag route. And he ran it a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line. But once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
And he'll find Everett there complete. And he's going to be taken down just shy of the 35. So the PI decline, and that'll give them a fresh set of downs.
And when you scout tight ends, one thing you want to know, just how strong they are. And we saw it in evidence there. He was able to fight through all the contact and still secure the football.
Herbert will give this one to Eckler. And he'll get it inside the 35.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defense in front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
Quick throw, knocked away, and incomplete.
Really good coverage all over the field, and it took away his intended read. And almost dared him to try for his guy out of the backfield. No surprise on that one. It doesn't connect.
Got to get to the 26 for a first. This is third down. Play action. It's Herbert. Over the middle, and it's caught. Keenan Allen. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys 19.
The Chargers passing game rolling a bit here. They've got another first. 2 minutes on the clock in what's been a scoreless first half. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. They go back to the ground now with Eckler. And he is out of bounds, but first he gets it inside the 10 to the 7. Although his reputation as a speedy runner precedes him, it's always fun to watch him work.
It is eye-opening, isn't it? Because when you see him get the ball and just go, in addition to that speed, it helps out his blockers. They don't have to hold blocks for long because he's just going to speed right past them.
And they'll send Williams in motion right. First down, and they stick with Eckler. And a minuscule gain of maybe a yard from the 6 to the 5.
The yards may start getting a little tougher to come by down here near the goal line. That's good work defensively there on first down, holding them to a short gain.
And the ball smack dab on the 5-yard line. Here's second and goal. Once more, here's Eckler. And he gets halfway there from the 6 to the 3 on a gain of 3. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next.
That run didn't get very far, and I think when you're looking at his dimensions, he's a little bit on the smaller side. He's counting on the big guys up front to escort him in, and they couldn't create any kind of space for him, could they?
Yeah, didn't get the push they needed. And that one going nowhere from the start as he's met in the backfield and goes backwards. Now a second timeout called for by the defense as they head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Hopkins' kick is good. So a long drive gets him down inside the 5, but ultimately they settle for just the field goal.
And I have to think that if maybe they were a yard closer, that would have made their decision tougher, and I think they likely would have gone for it. But in this situation, they just decided to take the 3, and I think it was a smart move.
This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And he's going to be taken down inside the 10 at about the 8-yard line.
Anytime you feel the kickoff inside your own end zone, you've got to be decisive about whether you're bringing it out or not. Sometimes that indecision can really cost you. That may have been what happened on that play.
And Prescott, his 3rd interception. Picked off by Asante Samuel Jr. And the Chargers are going to take possession of the football. And they'll take possession already in the red zone and in a great spot to add points to the scoreboard.
And Brandon, how many times have we seen a defense with a lot of field behind them get even more aggressive, right? They feel like they've got them not pinned down, but in a favorable spot for them. And they took advantage of it there. Got a nice interception.
And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Buried by multiple defenders on the drive's first play.
Well, certainly going to be a lot tougher adding a touchdown to that lead now since they're facing 2nd and 20+. Big time sack to start the drive and put the opponent way back. Let's see what kind of play call they come up with here.
They try to throw on 2nd down, but this one is incomplete.
I know conventional wisdom says, hey, don't get it all back in one play. But sometimes you go ahead and try to. They tried to get it all back on that one, weren't able to do so.
Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw. Under pressure, and he will go down. Sacked back at the 38. Now the Chargers will use the 2nd of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 32 seconds to go in the first half. And this is off target to the left. Didn't get there anyway. It's no good, and that will keep this a 3-point game.
And now 2 problems as I see it. First, you missed the kick, which granted was a long one. But 2nd, you set the other guys up a great field position and enough time to maybe get downfield and get a field goal attempt of their own.
Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 at the 45. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. He's going to find Gallup here complete. And he'll be brought down on the other side of midfield at the 43. Now the offense will burn their third and final timeout. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. Now Prescott, he'll fire deep downfield for Lamb, and he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
One thing that offensive guys stress when they throw the deep ball, you're just counting on your receiver to find it, adjust before the defensive back can get his head around. In this case, though, the DB matched it move for move and knocked it away.
Off play action to Elliott. Here's Prescott. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. That'll leave him with a third and two coming up. They got 8 yards there. And forthcoming, a field goal try for the Cowboys. From the left hash, this will be a 52-yard attempt. And the 11-year veteran bangs it through, and that will tie us at 3-3. That was perfect. From distance, he steps up, knocks it right down Main Street.
And Main Street's celebrating right now with him, aren't they? I love the mechanics of the whole thing. Snap, hold, everything was right on target, and the blocking was perfect, and he executed so, so well.
All we've had so far. 3-3 now as the kick is away. Pettis now from his end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. The Charger drive about to get going. And they'll have time for one play. It's 2 seconds on the clock. They'll indeed start on the ground to run that clock. And this will go as a short gain on what will be the final act of this first half. So we've reached halftime in a low-scoring affair, just a pair of field goals. 3-3 is our score as we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach. Now, alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, getting set for quarter number three here. Second half ready to roll. Two field goals, the combined output in half number one. Could be first touchdown wins. And we will not see a return to start the half as this will be a touchback. The Charger drive about to get going. Well, the first half, very even. I mean, really, in all facets, this ball game tied, Charles. So as we start the third quarter, curious to see what the second half brings us.
certainly am. I'm with you on that one. And we all know a lot of coaches from the NFL all the way down to the peewee level. They love to submit it to their teams. Hey, we're starting a brand new shorter ball game. It's all even. Let's go out and seize it. This is ours.
Well, they're in some hot water now after that sack. It's second and 21. A play fake, and now Herbert to throw, eluding the pressure right. He's airing it out for Williams, and he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Kelvin Joseph. And some space here. And the Cowboys are going to take possession of the football. If you combine last week and this week, he's got a hat trick going because he had two interceptions a week ago.
He's seeing the ball so well and understanding where receivers are, positioning. I mean, just watching him work with such great technique and paying it off by actually catching the ball when he has a chance, he's helping his team in a huge way.
Following the interception, here's Prescott. Oh, hit as he throws there, incomplete.
But these are the situations that really test a defense, those sudden changes. They're already inside field goal range to start the possession. Their goal now, keep it to a long kick if indeed they end up trying one.
They'll try again from the 36 on second and 10. And right side, they're going to go option here. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. And that one will go for 13 yards on the keeper and a first down. Out of the gun, here's Prescott. Under pressure and down he goes. They sack him back at the 36. So second and long, and got to be careful not to fall out of field goal range. Another try after the first down sack. Prescott, and he's going to hook up with his big tight end. Complete. A good pickup there, 13 yards as they get closer for third down.
We always hear from coaches how much they like to run crossing routes because they want to hit their receivers on the go, get them the ball, and keep them moving. How about when you hit a tight end that way? Okay, the receivers are going to run past you most of the time. The tight end, they can do their damage a different way, break a few tackles, and really...
And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Credit the sack to Joey Bosa.
We've watched this a long time, and I still don't believe we get it. Third and long, why are you calling play action?
Yeah, because they're not going to bite defensively, right?
No, not at all. I did have a coach explain to me years ago that for some teams, that's how they have to deal with pass protection and the line blocking. But to me, it seems silly.
Yeah, well, they are silly, and it leads to a play action sack. But whatever was said in the locker room during the break must have worked. They forced the turnover. They didn't get the touchdown, Charles, but it does translate into 3 points to begin this second half.
Exactly as they discussed in the locker room at halftime. Get some points to get things kick-started. Now start your half off with some momentum. Gives you something to build on for your next possession.
The Charger drive about to get going. And with the way this offense has played thus far, to be frank, they got to feel pretty grateful to be in the ball game.
I would agree with you totally because they've done all of nothing offensively in this game, yet they still find themselves in a position on this drive where a touchdown can give them the lead. They need to take advantage of it.
And they're still looking for that first touchdown here in the third quarter. All they have so far, the field goal.
They'll come up now second and four from the 31. The open man, it's Mike Williams. That one, a first down pickup of 8. That is catch number 300 now for his NFL career. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Up the middle with Eckler. And he'll manage to pick up about 4. It's second down.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime meetings had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secured before they slide off and try and chip someone at the second level.
He's got his man. That's Everett, the tight end. The Chargers passing game rolling a bit here. They've got another first.
When this offense can get their tight ends involved, they can move the football. Here, a nice route, able to look it in, and picks up the first down.
This is a counter play. Eckler, and he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 41. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
This defense is just flat getting after it. They have not given up much of anything in the run game. Case in point right there.
So the first down run lost a couple. Now they come up second and 12. Now Herbert with it, looking to pass. That's complete to his receiver, Pettis. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys 23. The Chargers passing game rolling a bit here. They've got another first. And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Eckler now between the tackles. And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
There's no question that coming into this game, this defense is pretty vocal about his desire to take this running back out of his game. And all that pregame whooping has turned into results.
A rare misstep on that last play because the drive has been strong, but now it's second and 12. Herbert off of play action. Williams brings it in, and they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, and watch him drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed too.
And he's maybe going to get this back to the 4, but that's about all. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal.
I don't know about you, Brandon, but I often think to myself, in these situations, I want a back who can create his own space, who can break tackles, and in a sense, become his own blocker. We don't have that guy in the game right now.
Now a second down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete.
On that snap, he's the hero of his defense after the play he just made. A one possession game, and his hit kept it exactly that.
This defense has not surrendered a touchdown yet. You better believe they're determined not to here on third and goal. Herbert now. To the goal line, but it's incomplete. So it's been a long drive. They've held the ball for quite a while. Now what do you do here?
Well, to me, at this stage, after this drive, this close to the goal line, 3 points would be a letdown. I'm going for it here.
Hopkins' kick is good. And in the fourth quarter, this game is tied. Well, you talk about clutch. That one was right down Broadway, and this game's all even here in the fourth.
Yeah, he didn't leave any doubt, did he? Good snap, good hold, dead center. Almost like a big-time golfer in a major, firing at a pin from the fairway, trying to win the tournament going down the stretch.
And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled it to 15. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And we essentially have a brand new ball game. After that last field goal has tied us all up, we brace for what should be an exciting rest to this fourth quarter. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. It's a loss of 4 on the first down play.
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness, he's the whole package. And that package just wrapped up the runner for a loss.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete.
We've seen these defenses make enough opportunistic plays to keep this one low scoring. Flying around, making plays on the ball, and we see yet another errant throw as a result.
He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field. And this is going to be intercepted. Derwin James with a pick. And the Chargers are going to take possession of the football.
Well, we say it often, Charles, but not all interceptions are created equally, and that is a big one here in a tie ball game in the fourth quarter.
And, Brandon, when games are this close, it usually comes down to the team making the fewest mistakes, and that was one of our mantras back at Tennessee. Coach Major say all the time, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. You've got to cut those down to give yourself an opportunity.
And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10. And the trend continues here in the fourth like it was in the first, second, and third. He's had nowhere to run.
And you're probably thinking to yourself, why do they keep feeding him the football? Well, they trust him first and foremost. They do believe that over time he might actually pop one of these runs. But bottom line is, he takes care of the ball.
Pressure applied, and he's going to be taken down. They sack him back at the 33-yard line. Credit the sack to Leighton Van Der Esch.
And this dominant defensive performance continued on that play. This poor quarterback has now received the protection he needs and has had to pick himself up off the turf far too often.
Gonna throw on third down with Herbert. And that's gonna be incomplete. The coverage, too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's fourth down. So on comes the kicker, Dustin Hopkins, in a big spot. This for the lead in the final stages. He's got the distance, but it's no good. Wide to the right, and a costly one there as this game remains tied here in the fourth. What a tough spot to miss a kick. Just an absolute letdown.
Look, they got themselves in the field goal range, gave them a chance to take the lead. They come up empty, and now you wonder, will their offense ever see the football again?
Yeah, because on the other side, one through the post, and this thing could be over.
Room here to run. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. An excellent way to start the drive there, 18 yards.
And I got to ask you, with these RPOs, essentially the quarterback has three options, right? So what's different from that versus the triple option that we see the service academies run at the college level?
As a general rule, the triple option at the college level, most things are called outside of the quarterback faking it to the runner and then keeping it himself and maybe having a trail back. And what I mean is, in the NFL, that option to throw the football all comes about organically. It's a natural deal based on reads. In college, if you're going to throw the football off a triple option, you've actually called that play.
The first down run got five. Here's second and five. Here's Dak. They'll set up the screen to Elliott. And they'll work this down inside the 30. The Chargers going to signal for the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next.
For as many sacks as this defense has, you can understand their willingness to try and get upfield and get another. So what a really smart play call here to use their aggression against them, go with the screen, and they're able to get the first down.
A give to Elliott running left
to the 27-yard line.
I like the call there because that was one to take time off the clock and get them closer to getting out of here with a W. In the mind of the play caller, all you want to hear is tick, tick, tick.
Second down and seven. Pollard gonna try the right side. Down right around the 25. Now the Chargers will use the second of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just over a minute to go in the game. They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains. Now Prescott.
That's incomplete, but there is a flag down. So hang on, a big call coming on third down.
So roughing the passer there, a big mistake defensively.
Yeah, and even though you've got a quarterback out of the pocket and the rules change downfield, that doesn't mean the same rules don't apply with the QB. Anything more than one step, they're going to throw a flag on you every time.
A bad time for a roughing penalty, and they get the gift of a first and 10. A handoff left, Elliott.
All right, my man, this is now where it's risk-reward, because on defense, you've got to crowd the line of scrimmage. You've got to get in all the gaps, get up tight on everyone, and try and force the field goal attempt here. You can't let them break one big, but you know something, when you crowd the line of scrimmage, if they do pop one, it's going
to
go.
Yeah, I was going to say, could take it to the house, but the magnitude of this possible upcoming field goal, every yard counts.
Call it a gain of a couple, and that's going to leave them with a third and about five. Now, what's the thinking here? Because a touchdown would be nice, but you've insured yourself a chance at three in the lead, so how worried are you about the six?
You're not very worried about if you're confident in your kicker. And if you got a kicker who can put it through the post, you feel really good about trying to bleed that clock down. In an ideal scenario, your kicker puts it through the post as the clock hits zeros.
And on third and five, this will be the eighth play of the drive. They go to Elliott again. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. And they get the timeout called here. It comes with 1 second remaining on the clock.
I think sometimes when you're trying to get after the quarterback, maybe it's better to be lucky than great, because I think on that one, he's just trying to get upfield and rush the passer. Instead, the tackle for the loss landed right in his lap.
And his kick is good. He knocks through his third field goal of the game, and this one is the one that decides it. And it'll be a good time in Big D tonight. The Cowboys have won it.
Well, obviously, Charles, this was by no means an offensive track meet. I mean, the defenses were the story in this ball game, but hey, they got enough points to get the job done, and at the end of the day, that's all that matters.
You're absolutely right about that, partner. In such a low-scoring game, it completely changes everything you had planned to do out there. Fortunately for them, they got just enough scoring to bring home the win, and in this type of a game, the play of their defense, that became one of their biggest keys.
So for Dallas, it's a win here in their home opener as they move to 2-0. And they will hit the road next week for a date with the Green Bay Packers. Meanwhile, for the Chargers, they'll fall to 1-1. And they'll be off to Minneapolis next week for a look at new U.S. Bank Stadium and a date with the Vikings.
Childhood, say anything in their raps cause it sound good. Don't even mean what they say, horrible outlook. I was in the house with it. We don't respect fake jewelry and silly outfits. Window down, blowing out great tits. New York's J Prince on Houston Street. I caught the bounce before my even bounced the beat. I took the hard way and it, man, it's the route for me. Run me the keys, run me the bees, run me that float back. The top three, I'm not number one. How could you post that? I would have crowned the city as mine. You cannot hold that. I'm not the one to go at. Meet Joe Black. Run me the keys, run me the bees, run me that float back. The top three, I'm not number one. How could you post that? I would have crowned the city as mine. You cannot hold that. I'm not the one to go at. Meet Joe Black. Meet Joe Black.
It's Madden NFL 23, and our focus is on the Lions' rocket arm quarterback. He got his reps in a week ago, over 400 yards through the air. It's the Lions and the Seahawks, and it's coming right up on EA Sports.